meet you, Walid. Good evening, brother.
Hi, good evening. Walid Norris. I'm with the Green Drinks Group. So we're a purely volunteer-run organization. We organize green drinks happy hours once a month in various venues across DC. Lately, we've been coming back to Glenn's Garden Market quite a bit. It's a great venue. We're really happy to be able to host our events here. And it's an opportunity for people from across the DC metro area to come and network with sustainability, open-minded people, discuss sustainability issues. This evening we've been discussing climate change. And essentially every evening we reach out to speakers that are so professional speakers that are working on these topics. And we also get an organization to sponsor the first round of drinks. So each attendee will...
That's a rare token you have there.
We'll get you one of these, absolutely.
Have you tasted it?
I tasted it. These craft beers from the region are absolutely delicious.
Speaking of
absolutely.
Which,
thank
we
you
have
very much.
There you go.
Cheers.
Is that the darker variety? What's the choice here?
So this is the IPA, right? Beautiful. It's delicious. You should come on down and check it out. So so I was saying, every evening we get once a month we get an organization to come and present. And tonight we had the Climate Reality Project come and talk to us about their great worldwide campaign to raise awareness and drive action on climate change. And I'm very happy to be able to introduce you to Olina, who works with the Climate Reality Project, and he's going to tell you a few words about the program.
And you've met Walid before then, right?
No, just tonight.
Really?
Right, this is the first time we've met.
And now you're drinking together. That's good.
I don't have a drink.
Yeah, you deserve a drink.
You deserve one of these.
There you go. Now that's a gentleman for you.
Yeah.
All right. So you were giving this presentation today. What was the reception? How did people receive it, do you think?
I think very well. I mean, we're speaking to an audience of environmental professionals, and so they know about the issues of climate change. They know how important it is, and they know how it's affecting their day-to-day life. So it's not a hard group to convince that the work we're doing is important. And so we hope to be able to get people involved and let them know about the campaigns and projects that we're focusing on for 2015. Really, our focus is trying to make a difference in the road to Paris, with Paris COP coming up at the end of 2015. So that's okay. Really where our campaigns will be focused for the year. And we're really excited. We think there's a lot of potential here.
Okay, give us a pitch on what it is that you're hoping to achieve from this event today. Because you got all these folks here that are obviously appreciating this.
Absolutely, yeah. We've been overwhelmed by the response this evening. We were actually worried that there would be too many people showing up and we'd have to turn people away, but it's been great.
That would be a crime if you had to turn away.
Everyone's been welcome. It's worked out really well. In fact, I just wanted to quickly introduce you to one of our previous sponsors. So Jeff is with SolarCity, and he can tell you about how green drinks and how the venue has worked for you in the past here.
Well, thanks so much for putting me on the spot, Wally.
Why not?
I really appreciate it.
Get used to it.
I wasn't sure what I was getting myself into here, but it's a phenomenal venue to really talk about the issues that you're passionate about, right? So if you really care about something, the idea is that you want to spread that to other people and hopefully that you can bridge that information gap. And for myself, it's solar power and how we can have residential systems on millions and millions of homes. For other people, it's the Climate Reality Project and the issues that are important to them. So it's a lot of people that are very passionate about similar issues coming together, and it makes us feel good about ourselves from time to time. That's important too.
So SolarCity actually produces solar panels, or what type of
industry? We're currently building a manufacturing facility in Buffalo, New York, that will be roughly a 1 gigawatt manufacturing facility, hopefully to expand in the future.
Now, is that going to provide some relief for the grid? Because we hear about how vulnerable our grid is in general. So is that going to help mitigate
that? Sounds like we have a solar fan right here.
You have an energy specialist.
That's right. So one of the really neat things about solar energy is that when the sun is up, we typically are using power. Mm-hmm. So solar panels produce power when we use power. Mm-hmm. And therefore, it helps make the grid bit more efficient, yes.
Okay. Correct. So, and also you won't have to worry about some of the other concerns, not only the grid, but power outages, et cetera, because people control that more?
No, so unfortunately the systems that we have right now are grid-tied solar systems, meaning that in order for the solar panels to function, the grid needs to function as well. It's a regulation in the National Electric Code. It's a little nerdy, but with batteries we'll be able to change that.
Okay, yeah. So for now this is kind of the first evolution, and then you have bigger plans in the long run.
Elon Musk is one of our major investors, and one of the things that's really, really neat about Solar City and Tesla is that we'll likely be able to use batteries in the future to have that backup power. So the backup power, it could be mobile, it could be lots of things that we're not even thinking of yet. But right now the grid is up 99% of the time or more, and we're really focusing on that percentage of the time.
Okay, so again, is SolarCities at .com or?
Yeah, that's SolarCity.com.
You were lucky to get that one, whoever is involved. Are you a founder, or you sound like you could be a representative at least?
Sound like a founder, huh?
Yeah.
I'm a sales representative of sorts. Yes. Yeah,
you've been trained by the best, though, right?
The best in the company.
Yeah, I assume so. You can make a living doing this, right?
That's what I try to do. Yeah.
All right. Well, you sold me, and I really appreciate your information. Cool. Thanks for your time. So, Walid, has this been a good event? You have somebody
else? Absolutely. Listen, I wanted to introduce another friend of Green Drinks. So we have Max Edkins.
Step on up to the table. Oh, you guys are all male model material here. What is it?
Yeah. Yeah,
you just happen to be, you know, good-looking guys.
I can't keep
this hair. There you go.
There we go.
All right. Well, so I assume you're selling something also, right?
That's
well,
right. Well, let's hear who you are first.
Todd Wiggins. My business is called Urban Revival Media. I've been in D.C. for 20-plus years.
Okay.
I've interviewed people like yourselves who are visionaries that understand how business works, that actually understand how events work and how to use an event to promote a product or a concept or a long-term vision. So there you go. All right. So how about you?
Okay, so my name is Max Edkins. I work for Connect for Climate, which is the climate communications program of the World Bank. We're externally orientated, and we're a partnership organization where we try to incorporate all our member partners from academia, from the private sector, to big international institutions. Being based at the World Bank, we're able to reach out to basically across the world. We've got memberships really in every country of the world. We tend to energize youth to engage with the climate movement, to seek for climate solutions, and to get part of coming to a global agreement for climate action. And we're always excited to be part of these kind of networking opportunities in DC, where we can also hear from like-minded members and people that are doing very similar stuff and figure out how we can partner together.
Okay. And so there's a business concern, but it's a social concern. And then is there an international consensus on best practices that comes from this at all?
Well, I think climate change has really come to the forefront in the last 5 to 10 years. Mm. And you can also see it at the World Bank, where it's been incorporated into all practices of engagement over the last couple of years. We've got a new climate change department, and we've got great leadership with Jim Kim and Rachel Kite, who are advocates for climate action, and they're working on a high level political front to really come to a global agreement on climate action at the end of this year at the Paris negotiations in December. And under that kind of leadership, it's just really exciting to kind of bring in civil society, to bring in youth around the world, and help advocate for climate solutions.
Okay, so it's all in the works right now.
Yeah, it's happening.
As far as some of the agreements are concerned.
We're taking this forward. We're going to come to a solution by the end of the year. We're going to act on climate change, and climate change is going to be incorporated into every aspect of our dealings. It's going to be the new economy,
okay.
No doubt.
Now, do the Chinese know this?
Absolutely.
This is going to be happening? Okay. So where do you start? I mean, when the climate change legislation that comes with this is going to be passed, I assume at some point.
There's so many fronts to start on. There's so many different wedges you can integrate climate change into. One major aspect is to put a price on carbon, to make sure that the economic equations actually work out for the environment and for climate action. The other thing is to get rid of harmful subsidies. Then you can invest in the right technologies, invest in the future, shift towards green bonds rather than damaging fossil fuel bonds. There are many aspects. You can work on the international level, you can work on the regional level, you can work on the city level, you can work on transport, go for more inclusive public transport as opposed to individual fossil fuel vehicle transport. You can work with cities around their green infrastructure and their resilience. There's so many different levels, and I think with global awareness really incorporating this, it is the economy of the future. It is the economy that everybody wants to be part of.
Okay, so right now the Transportation Research Association convention is taking place at the Convention Center here at the Washington Building, Walter Washington Convention Center. Is it a coincidence that you happen to be here when that's going on?
Actually, no. But it'll be great to see what's happening there.
Okay, well, you got two more days, okay? So
there's some really exciting news coming out of transportation in the U.S. with the first high-speed rail construction started in California. I think that's really exciting. So
that's true.
We'll be watching that very closely.
Okay, so that's one of the issues and topics that you will really want to bring to the forefront.
It's sustainable solutions, you know, that are all, you know, focused on developing a world that's more sustainable and climate friendly. Absolutely.
Well, getting the countries to work together, that seems like that would be the hard part.
That's the harder part. Yeah. But it's great to see kind of the citizen engagement, you know, the fact that businesses are really involved. And so it's there's this great momentum behind this.
Well, you have good reason to be optimistic, especially
Absolutely.
When you have a fine girl in front of you. All right.
That's
well,
right.
Again, thank you to our hosts,
All right.
Glenn's, right?
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
If people want to be involved, how can they do that? How can they contact you?
The best thing to do is go on Facebook, join the Green Drinks DC group, and you'll be able to find out about all the upcoming events, which happen on a monthly basis, usually the second Tuesday of the month.
Okay, beautiful.
And last
but not least, I'd like to see that rare coin that you have here.
It's gone now. It's been used.
Oh, yeah. I hear you. All right. Well, thank you so much for your time.
No worries. Okay. Let me see if there's a spare one knocking around.
Okay, appreciate it.
All right? Okay.